Ketchy did what?
He turned himself into the police. Sis told me yesterday. He's admitted to being the perpetrator behind the recent cases.
So he's alive.
Ketchy-kun survived and owned up to what he did.
Well, I feel it's for the best. If Ketchy-kun is alive and he can atone for his crimes, that's not a bad turn of events.
Right. Ain't that all stuff to be happy about?
Mm-hmm. It's Christmas. We should enjoy the day to our heart's content.
I approve. Let everyone be merry to the max.
I'm the one who should be giving permission, you know. Well, as long as you don't go overboard, I guess you can go ahead and cut loose today.
Hell yeah! Merry Christmas!
He didn't hear a word of that. Fine.
Oh my! This is quite a sight.
I'm going to be entirely honest. I wasn't able to bring a dish. Instead, leave the dishwashing duties to me. I'll make sure they turn out beautifully immaculate.
Why don't we all just clean up together?
So, who brought what?
I brought that marinated seafood.
That's super good!
It may not be to everyone's tastes, but I brought that cheese plate.
Whoa! That smells like dirty socks.
Oh. Oh, but it tastes great.
Thank goodness. Oh, is this a croquembouche? It's so cute.
I made that all by myself. All I did was buy some cream puffs and stack them up, though.
It's been arranged so artistically that I hesitate to sample it. When it comes to sweets, An truly has us beat.
But then, who brought this box over here?
Ooh, this looks like more sweets. Not mine, by the way.
Me? Kinda?
Ryuji brought sweets?
Ryuji and sweets.
Sweets.
Hey, what are you guys getting at?
It was just a bit unexpected, is all. I had expected something along the lines of meat. For some reason, chicken comes to mind when I think of you.
Ryuji, chicken.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean that in any sort of comparative way.
Please don't keep going. It just hurts even more.
Did you hear what I just said?
Come on, don't get all depressed. Everyone's here to party.
Everyone. Oh.
Mona-chan.
I was trying my best not to mention it, but it's hard to avoid.
If only Mona could be here with us.
Someone call for me?
Yeah, we were just talking about... Huh?
Wait, what? No way! I thought you disappeared!
Looks like the only me that disappeared was the one in the metaverse.
So, you stayed in reality as a cat?
When I woke up, I was out in Shibuya looking like this. I headed back here right away, but it took a surprising amount of time.
If you were coming back here, you should have told us, moron!
We were so worried!
Sheesh. Well, I brought my own surprise back, too. I brought some fried chicken. This doesn't have anything to do with your conversation earlier, though. Any room left on the table?
Oh, now there's our chief for ya.
Talk about everything falling into place.
Come on, let's get started. We're gonna party to celebrate our hard work and my grand return.
Don't push your luck.
And things are finally back to normal.
Here, try this one.
year-end party, huh? I'm already excited!
Thank you for inviting me. Although, I admit, I feel a bit like I'm intruding.
There's no need for modesty. After all we've been through, there are no strangers here.
Yeah, you really helped him out too.
In that case, I'll accept your offer.
Yo, I really can't stop staring at that thing you're wearing.
So it's caught your eye as well. It happened to catch mine while I was strolling through the city. I bought it for myself as a reward for the end of the year. What do you think about the scarf? You've recognized its unique beauty as well.
I'd say it's a little too unique.
This fashion chat is fine and all, but if you don't dig into that soba soon, it's gonna get soggy on you.
Ah, yes, my apologies. Thank you for the food.
It's chow time!
Mmm, so good!
Sakura-san, you made these noodles yourself, right? They're amazing! You could open a soba restaurant!
Oh, thanks. I made a little too much, so if anyone wants a refill...
Seconds, please!
How fast do you eat? You eat a lot more than I'd assumed you do, Yoshizawa-san.
I don't know if that fully explains what's happening here.
Senpai, don't kid them so much. My appetite's totally normal.
Breaking news on our top story. After nearly 2 weeks of silence, the prosecutor's office is planning to move forward with the biggest case of the year. They have announced that they will move forward in the charging of Representative Shido for his confessed crimes.
It's finally happening.
I was planning on telling all of you about this a little later. This case is all thanks to a certain man's testimony. But I can at least share this one piece of good news with you.
And that would be?
The woman involved in his false charge case has finally come forward and provided her testimony. I can't say for certain yet, but his criminal record may very well be overturned.
For real?
That's wonderful! Congratulations, Senpai!
Of course, this is highly confidential, got it?
What great news! Looks like we really will be having a happy new year.
This is incredible! It's an actual, real-life good ending!
And after that, the two-hour New Year special of Tokyo Vice. A thrilling tale, jam-packed with some of the network's most famous faces. I'll never give up!
I've been seeing this guy on TV all the time lately.
Oh yeah, he's a model turned actor. With a figure like that, I can see how he's gotten so popular.
So he's popular, eh? If I were more like that human, maybe Lady An would...
The year is winding down to its final moments. Let's take a look at how people are spending it all across the country.
Now that I'm thinking about it, hell of a lot sure did happen this year.
Right? It's like, how many years of our lives did we actually live through this year?
I doubt we'll experience anything even similar to it for quite some time.
Well, this is just from my point of view, but I really hope that's the case.
And I guess starting next year, we'll just be good boys and girls at school.
If that's the case, then I assume you'll be able to handle your summer break homework on your own, right?
Please don't go there, Senpai.
I don't think I see that happening.
Okay, that's a
fine. I can't do it alone. I mean, what do I even do as an honor student?
So much has happened over the past 12 months. But in the end, we got to spend it together like this. I want to believe that this was a great year for us.
Yeah, I don't have any proof, but I feel like next year is going to be even better for us.
I feel the exact same way. How strange.
Well, that's only natural, considering how pleased we are with our end-of-year celebration.
Young people have been gathering in Shibuya all day for the big countdown at midnight, and this crowd is...
I really don't want to get going, but it seems like it's time.
See you next year, right?
Next year? Sojiro, Oseji time! Get those New Year's dishes ready! Chop chop! And don't forget the black beans!
Yeah, I hear ya. If I start prepping the beans now, they'll be ready by the morning. Don't worry about the food. You just go have a good night's sleep.
To the others, okay? But even after I disappeared, I was still vaguely conscious, and being separated from all of you was really scary. I thought, if it's even a little bit possible, I wanted to come home to you guys. That's why I'm so glad I was able to come back here. Yeah, thanks. Well, it's pretty late. Let's get to sleep. I know I've said this before, but I hope we keep sticking together like this.
Results track meets alongside everyone else on the team, and eventually I'd get a hold of some scholarships for college to make things easier for my mom.
If that never happened, I would have gotten to enjoy my time in high school with Shiho.
My sister's been supporting the family. It's unrealistic to demand any more. I'm helping Okumura Foods grow, with my father watching over me.
I'm so happy.
counting on you.
Sorry to make work your first activity in the new year. Oh, that reminds me. Happy New Year. And I hope you'll continue getting along with Futaba and myself.
We're especially grateful you're open today. You know how everything on TV for New Year's is the same old, same old.
Say, boss, don't you have any plans for this morning?
I could cook some up, so long as you serve yourself everything and pay your bill on the way out.
Ah, right. Can't exactly make plans when you've already got customers.
How about you, young man? Are you going to the shrine for the new year?
That's a wise choice.
Happy New Year. That's what you say today, right? Nice meeting you too. Wait, what are you talking about? Are you still half asleep or something?
Oh, looking sharp.
Oh, you look absolutely lovely, Futaba-chan.
I picked it out with my mom. Sorry, I don't want to be late to the shrine. More showing off comes later. Well, time to make like a tree.
The year's first shrine visit, eh? What do you think we should do?
Well, perhaps we don't need to go this year. We don't have any more wishes that need granting.
What's up? Did you have plans for today or something? Oh, come on, you should have just said as much then. I'll be fine here, so off you go. Have fun. Oh, but it's pretty cold out there, so don't forget to dress warm so you don't catch a bug.
You a New Year's card, so here we are. Well, shall we? I wonder why. There aren't many people here at all. It's really unexpected. I'd almost prefer the usual crowd.
Yeah, and the end of the year was just a few hours ago.
Mm-hmm. Believe it or don't? Only 364 days until the next one.
That is true, but...
I know I'm gonna use the wrong year for a while.
Well, I have an idea. New Year's party tonight to help switch gears?
Huh?
Didn't expect you two here.
How many coincidences can there be in one day? And a good morn unto you all. I haven't seen you in absolute ages.
We were hanging out just yesterday.
Oh, I guess we all had plans to drop by here first thing today, huh?
That would explain what led us to the shrine, but to this spot at the exact same time? Talk about incredible happenstance.
Indeed, but due to this fortuitous turn of fate, I am able to witness this mesmerizing sight. Truly the embodiment of Japanese beauty.
What are you doing, Kitagawa-senpai?
Just ignore him. It's like a fit he gets into sometimes.
So, what do you want to do after this? If we've got the time for it, why don't we grab something to eat together?
I'm sorry, I'll be heading out with my family once we're finished here.
I have somewhere to be as well.
Me too. I'll be dining with my father somewhere.
I'm gonna hit up some New Year's sales with my mom.
Well, looks like you're all busy. And maybe I should hit up the track team and see what they're up to.
Ooh, I'll get in touch with Shiho and find out if she has any plans yet. Well, I guess we'll all just go do our own thing then.
See you later.
Looks like it's just us now. Oh, I was wondering earlier, what did you wish for at the Shrine, Senpai? You're starting the new year with quite the passionate wish, Senpai. Me? Well... Oh, I'm sorry. It's from my dad. He's telling me that some relatives have come over to the house, so I have to go home and spend some time with them. He decided to come all the way out to the station to get me. My family's kind of serious about their get-togethers. I'm really sorry. I was the one who invited you here and everything. At least allow me to accompany you to the station. Dad!
You should hold on to your sleeve. That is your dress kimono, after all. Who do we have here? I believe this is our first time meeting.
This is my senpai. The one I told you about before? My senpai who's done so much for me.
Oh, so you're her senpai. My daughter talks about you all the time.
Dad! Not all the time!
Is that not so? I was told you picked these out for me too. I know it's pretty late for it, but thank you all the same.
Dad wears them all the time, even at work.
I'm quite the fan of them. Well, shall we get going?
What?
Something wrong?
No, nothing. Well then, Senpai, please excuse us.
What's up? Who am I? Hey, you've been acting kind of weird since yesterday. What's going on?
Are you two still sleeping? Your lunch is gonna pull a vanishing act if you don't come down soon.
Ooh. Oh, you can go on ahead. I'll be down in a sec.
They're all perfectly shaped and so shiny. Looks like your recipes have reached housewife-level quality. You trying to get hitched sometime soon?
Thanks, but no. Hey, come join us.
Try the sweet black beans. They'll change your life!
Good morning. Oh, is this your first gag of the new year?
Drunk on the spirit of the new year already, huh?
I'll warn you not to try any pranks with Wakaba. It'll only blow up in your face. She'll tease you forever until she finally bores herself.
You know me too well.
Wakaba. Your work and your kid were so fulfilling for you. Why'd you have to die so suddenly?
What's up? Not feeling so good?
He's been like this since yesterday.
Morning, Mona.
Morning. Do you think there's enough Osechi for me to join you? Don't tell you what? Morgana's arrived for breakfast? Seriously, are you all right?
Okay, that's enough joking around for now. Go ahead and grab a seat. I bet you're just hungry.
Thank you for the food. I can't remember the last time I actually got to relax and enjoy myself on a New Year's like this.
I'm stuffed too. If only I had something to cap off this meal. Like a cup of coffee?
Boy, that was a subtle request.
Oh, does anybody want dessert with their coffee? I'll go pick it up. My treat. You want a Mont Blanc, right, Mom?
Oh, how kind. Thank you.
All right, I shall return.
Be careful.
What's the matter?
Sorry, we haven't opened for the day yet.
My apologies. I merely wish to speak with him for a moment.
Why don't you go and get some fresh air with him? I'll stand guard over your dessert for you.
You say that now, but when he gets back and his dessert's gone, I'm pretty sure he'll suspect it was an inside job.
I can definitely see that happening with Mona on guard duty.
Hey, come on, guys.
Sorry.
I guess I'll start the coffee.
You know, don't you? We have to discuss this. That's what I need to discuss with you. Come on. Well then, let's try to sort through this situation. That seems as good a place to begin as any. At the end of last year, I turned myself into the police as the perpetrator of the serial psychotic breakdown incidents. Your memory of this is still intact, correct? Perhaps the most confusing part of my story comes post-detainment. Obviously, I was thoroughly interrogated about my involvement in Shido's case. But for some reason, after questioning, I was suddenly released. No explanation whatsoever. I agree. No matter how one attempts to rationalize it, my release is extremely unusual. More than that, it should be impossible for them to release a confessing suspect after only a brief interrogation. But what's even more unbelievable to me is... That is indeed quite strange. But what's even more abnormal is... Wakaba Ishiki. I can't believe she's been brought back to life. For the time being, you seem to be the only one who's still in their right frame of mind. I should get to the point. Let's make a deal. What say we join forces on this? I want to investigate what exactly is happening here. I'm fairly certain you wish to find out the same thing, no? For the time being, you and I share the same goal. To solve this problem, don't you agree that it'd be safer for us to partner up? Have you made up your mind? Well, first I need information. Can you tell me what happened after... parting ways with me in Shido's palace? I see. Though some abnormalities appeared immediately, the most glaring ones arrived after the new year. And all of the Phantom Thieves, with you as the sole exception, are living in this altered reality without even realizing it. Go ahead.
Senpai, it's Yoshizawa. I'm in Odaiba right now, and, I don't really understand what I'm seeing, but I'm just going to describe it to you. It's that building. It's really faint, but I can see that palace thing that Morgana-senpai mentioned a while ago. Senpai, I know this is sudden, but could you come to Odaiba right away? I understand. I'll see you soon.
That was Yoshizawa-san's voice, wasn't it? I believe I heard her say the word palace. Despite not being in the metaverse. You're planning to meet up with Yoshizawa-san, right? I'll join you. We're all but guaranteed to find a clue there. Now that we've made ourselves a new deal, you wouldn't turn me down, would you?
Senpai! And... Akechi-san?
We just happened to be together when he got your call. First a dead woman returns, and now a palace appears. How intriguing.
Akechi-san, you know about palaces?
Would it help you grasp the situation if I told you that I have the same powers he has?
Really? Does that mean you're also...
Allow me to stop you there. I'm not a part of the Phantom Thieves. However, since you've already grasped the concept, it's clear to me that you're a fellow Persona user.
Yes, I can use a Persona as well. I'm not a part of the Phantom Thieves either, though. I just so happened to slip into this palace with him and Morgana-senpai a while ago. But what could be the meaning behind its appearance here? I just happened to be passing by on my way home when I came across it.
Since nobody else is making a scene about it, I assume others aren't able to see it. Or they see it, but it doesn't evoke any real reaction in them.
Yes, that's exactly it. I asked some people in the area, and none of them seem to care at all about its appearance.
Rather than simply hypothesize out here, we may be better off taking immediate action.
You mean, we should go into the palace?
Not only has a palace manifested in reality, but this is the only one visible to us. I realize I have no proof, but it's highly likely that this is related to our current incomprehensible situation. Wouldn't it be more efficient to just go inside and see what we can learn? That is, if we have the means to do so. Oh, it's... I thought it was gone for good, but it looks like we've regained access to the nav.
I have it as well.
Is there a search history?
Search history? How do I check? Ah, there's one search in the log, but...
The name portion of the entry has been censored somehow. Could this be the doing of the palace's ruler?
Does that mean we can't enter the palace?
Well, we do have the search history, so it should be possible to infiltrate it anyway.
If you're going in, would you be willing to bring me with you? I can't put my finger on it, but something's been bothering me about this place ever since we first entered it. I promise I won't slow you down.
What's your call?
That settles it.
All right. Let's do it.
Now that I'm getting a second look here, I've noticed just how mysterious this place is.
what could this building even be?
It depends on what the palace's ruler thinks of the place. We'll likely find that out if we keep pushing forward.
Is that so? By the way,
what's the matter?
Well, I'm not sure how to put it. True outfit.
Oh, you mean this old thing? Yoshizawa-san aside, there's no reason for me to uphold the pretense of a righteous, sincere detective prince. Enough chatting. Let's move out.
Oh, it's a treasure chest! What should...
Now, let us depart.
Those geysers. You aren't among those who desire salvation. Leave! You are unwanted intruders. Do not disturb our Lord's research. This world's salvation.
The language of a shadow is a hint into its ruler's ideology. This one sounds rather cultish, for example. Sorry, but we're going to pass through there now. We don't have the time to waste on peons like yourself.
Why do you willingly strive for self-suffering? Why are you reaching out to your own pain?
Yoshizawa-san, you can do this, right?
Yes. Ready whenever.
It'll be too much trouble to go about this haphazardly. I'll provide the support. Look at this scum pile up. Fine by me. Time for a bloodbath. It's been quite a while. Nothing gets me quite as excited as this.
Akechi-san!
Now, time to obliterate them.
All right!
Come back,
Kitsune!
You're mine!
Let's dance! Sundrion! Persona!
Blows!
I think we handled that rather well, didn't we? Especially considering the last-minute arrangement of our team and all. Yoshizawa-san?
Yes. So that shadow, it said something about research, and also something about pain.
It mentioned salvation as well. All this seems to indicate that the palace's ruler is not in his or her right mind.
Oh?
I seem to have found a map to this place. Let's make good use of it.
So I've only shared pleasantries with Akechi-san. Would you say this is how he normally is? Like a ruthless sort of person. I see.
What say we save the idle chatter for later and keep moving? Unless teaming up with a ruthless sort of person is too much for you to handle.
Looks like we're busted.
What?
That voice! Look! No way!
Everyone will be arriving soon. Mom, Grandma. Yes, she'll be here too. I'm sure she'll be here, once she's able to calm down. Oh, why? Why?
Dad? Why?
That was your father in the video just now, wasn't it, Yoshizawa-san? And the one he was speaking to.
Sumire. My younger sister, Sumire Yoshizawa. I mentioned to you that I've lost a family member, right? But how was this video? I'm sorry. I don't know what's been wrong with me lately. I've been getting this feeling like I need to remember something, but at the same time, I oughtn't remember it.
Can you still walk, Yoshizawa-san? Whatever it is that's happening, we have to keep going if we hope to learn more about it.
Yes. I'm all right. Let's go.
Hey. When was it that you said you became acquainted with Yoshizawa-san? I see. Anyway, let's move out. I suspect we still have a long way to go.
This place is enormous. What could this room be?
You seem to be in pain again. Are you all right?
I'm fine. It's just that I can't stop thinking about that video we saw earlier.
You mean the one about Sumire-san?
Yes. Let's keep pushing. I need to find out why that was shown to me.
Misguided. Do not search for pain. Only tragedy awaits you beyond here.
A newcomer.
All these warnings of pain and tragedy. Who is your ruler? Why do you all think you know so much about me? If you won't give me an answer, then I'll just force my way through.
Rushing into things. Just calm down.
Oh, I'm sorry.
This is it. Time your attacks with mine.
Right.
Zona.
Persona! Let's finish this!
What? Damn.
Persona! Loki!
He's not hurt. Come on!
Let's go.
Tsunagino Okami Bigoro!
Power courses through me.
Such a fool, rejecting our Lord's mercy. In that case, witness it for yourself.
Now what?
Oh wow, the crowd is going wild. Their cheers are shaking the stadium to welcome a new heroine to the world of competitive gymnastics.
Huh?
Thank you so much. I'm simply thrilled with the results I had today. Your performance exceeded anything seen before in the junior class. It was absolutely stunning. But you'll be entering high school soon. Will that impact your career in gymnastics? Oh, I have no intentions of stopping. It's my dream to compete and win at the international level. How wonderful. One last question. Is there anyone you'd like to give a shout out while you have the chance? My younger sister! She should be here in the stadium!
What?
Oh, there she is! Sumire! Sumire! I did it! Both of us have the same dream, to be international champions!
Stop.
Let's make it come true, Sumire. Together!
Stop it! I...
Yoshizawa-san? You're...
I really hope this helped you understand.
A man's voice.
If you keep pushing on like this, you're going to find nothing but heartache. Please, won't you stop fighting this and just return to the current reality?
Nothing but heartache, huh? I don't understand what you're saying, but I have no intention of leaving now!
We are in agreement there. We also refuse to do as you say. Now why don't you drop the big voice behind the curtain act and face us directly?
As you wish. Head on down. I'll meet you there.
He agreed to that much more readily than I expected. Perhaps the palace's ruler really will make his appearance.
Thanks for your concern. But I'm fine, really. Let's go.
Kasumi Yoshizawa, eh?
Is he this palace's
It's been quite a while, hasn't it?
Dr. Maruki!
Glad to see you're all doing well. I pretty much figured that you would end up infiltrating this place. Truth be told, this isn't how I was hoping we would meet again.
Dr. Maruki, you're the ruler of this palace?
Palace?
A place where distorted desires manifest. We're asking if you're the source of the desires here.
Ah, I see. Well, to use your own words, yes, I am this palace's ruler. But in my case, it seems a tad different from the ones you've seen.
Would we also be correct in believing that you're involved in the abnormalities outside the palace as well?
Yes, you would. Do you like the reality I created for you?
You created it?
That's right. I have gained the power to alter reality, to make it whatever the people wish for. Is that how you really feel? The old reality was cruel and unfair. The truth is, Yoshizawa-san suffers immense pain each and every time she taps into her forgotten past.
My past? Dr. Maruki? What do you mean? What's happened to me?
All right. I had honestly hoped that all those warnings you were given would change your minds. But if it's your true desire, then I want you to recall who you really are. And I want you two to learn as well. Once you have, you'll need to choose between the two realities. The merciless one, or the one I've formed.
Today was brutal, huh? Oh. Feeling okay? It's not that. Why am I doing so bad? I keep messing up my routine.
Your growth spurts just changed your eye level. You'll get used to it. Look, you're as tall as I am now.
We practice the same amount. But you are the one who always gets first place. I can't catch up to you, Kasumi.
You know why? Because it's my right as the elder sister.
We're in the same grade, though.
Oh, don't be so down. We'll reach the top of the world together. That's our dream, right?
You don't get it.
Huh?
You'll never understand how I feel.
What?
Kasumi, if I were like you, things would be so much better.
Hey, wait up!
Kasumi's the one that people want.
Look where you're going! The light's red! Hey!
The talented one who can reach the top of the world.
Sumire, stop! Listen to me! Samiri!
Hey, look out! Stop!
What? Kasumi!
Seems you remembered.
That's right. I'm... Kasumi? No. That's not right. I'm not Kasumi.
The girl named Kasumi Yoshizawa is currently deceased.
It was last spring. Before I started at Shujin, we were walking home from practice. It happened right there, on that street in the video. I wasn't looking where I was going. And Kasumi, she protected me from the car. I was saved by Kasumi. I robbed her of her dreams, and even her life. I'm her younger sister, Sumira Yoshizawa.
I'll take over from here. After all, I do play a part in this story. Her real name is Sumira Yoshizawa. She's Kasumi-san's younger sister, but for months now, she's only seen herself as being Kasumi Yoshizawa, her deceased elder sister. Of course, it was only her cognition of herself that changed, so to the people around her, she was still Sumire-san. For some reason, though, there were a few rare exceptions to this. Did something happen to make you believe she was Kasumi-san?
It appears you were clueless, but she was Sumire Yoshizawa from the start. However, when we watched that other video, she gave her name as Kasumi Yoshizawa. Considering such an odd claim, I'd actually suspected for a moment that she was the palace ruler.
After Kasumi died, but before I started at Shujin, I received counseling from Dr. Maruki. That was when I told him, if Kasumi is gone and can't make her dream come true, then I want to become Kasumi, so I can turn her dream into reality for her.
So that's why you meddled with her cognition? For her own wishes?
That's right. Limited as it was, I already had the power at the time to actualize her wish. Put yourselves in her shoes for a moment. Sumire-san's older sister died from protecting her. Imagine surviving such a dismal tragedy. Who would be able to cope with that survivor's guilt, let alone heal from the emotional scarring that she suffered? If Sumire-san can live a healthy, positive life by becoming Kasumi-san, then I believe that reality is what would make her happy.
I've had enough of your high and mighty rationalization. All you really did was use her to try and make everyone acknowledge the validity of your research.
So that's how you see things, huh? That's quite unfortunate. Of course I wanted society to acknowledge cognitive science through my research. But that's because my goal is to save everyone in the world like Yoshizawa-san by ending all suffering. My work will convert the wishes of the people into reality. Even as we speak, my research is coming to fruition. No one will ever have to suffer again under the yoke of an unfair world. This palace, you called it? It's a place where its ruler's desires take physical form, yes? I wish to utilize my research to save humanity. I suppose that would be the desire I hold dearest.
What total nonsense.
You could very well be right. Still, I'm entirely serious about changing our imperfect reality. Just as she was saved by becoming Kasumi, I'll save every other person in the world currently suffering. In fact, it's my responsibility to do so. You can see how this world's bestowed the duty upon me. I don't know for certain. It'll most likely be treated as if it never existed. The cruel reality will cease to be, and the reality I generate will be the sole world recognized by society.
And you assume we'll buy into your brainwashing and just live in the palm of your hand. Honestly, that sounds absolutely revolting.
All right, so that's your answer, Akechi-kun. How about the others? Yoshizawa-san, allow me to ask you yet again, which reality is it that you wish to inhabit?
Huh?
If you so desire, you can return to your life as Sumire. But if you'd rather continue your life as Kasumi, I can grant that wish for you as well.
Dr. Maruki... Hi. It's impossible. I'm sorry, Senpai. I can't go back to being her. I can't be the one who led her sister to her death.
Please don't judge her. This is just evidence of how painful life is for her. You two sensed doubts forming in the reality I manifested. That's what brought you here. But please, remember this as well. You two aren't excluded from the people that I wish to save. Come now. Won't you accept my reality for your own happiness? No deal so far, huh?
What do you think you're doing with her?
I won't harm her. It's in her best interest that you turn back. You've made clear that you reject the reality she desires. The reality where she lives as Kasumi Yoshizawa. It saddens me when you speak that way. Don't you understand? You deny her wishes when you say such things.
Her wishes, huh?
This isn't just for her. I'm doing all of this for yourselves as well. I honestly do want to come to terms with you. We should talk. Think about it. You both have dreams, no? I have the power to make them come true. My reality can become just the way you like.
Total waste of my time.
A shame, but I understand.
Well then, we just have to resort to force now, don't we?
Violence is not my thing. I agree, though. It seems we're out of options here.
Time to fight. Are you ready? Keep up, and don't embarrass me. Disgusting. We're not here to listen to your bullshit. Fear my power. Shitsune!
Come on! persona! Manifest!
Let's go.
Ravage them!
No! Such pathetic attempts won't be enough! As this!
This just won't go down! We're about to lose a lot of...
Accept his mercy. Give yourselves over to him.
Would you just quit running your mouth already? Joker, I'm going to shut that thing up. Give me a hand.
You'll pay.
Let's go! Shall we continue this? I'm fairly certain any further negotiating is pointless.
That seems to be the case, unfortunately. But first, I have an idea. Rather than explain it with words, I'd like you to actually see this new reality with your own eyes. I know that your friends are already enjoying it. That I cannot do. As I said before, she wishes to live in the reality where she is Kasumi. There's no way I can hand her over to you with matters as they currently are. I already told you that I won't harm her, and I'll swear by it. Don't worry about her. Go. Look at the reality I've created for you all. Once you've seen the results, I know you'll realize which future is best.
You think we'll just obey your orders?
I apologize, but you really are going through with this, even if it's by force.
We'll meet again 1 week from today, January 9th. I genuinely pray that you'll change your mind by then.
He got away. We shouldn't chase him too far. Let's say we head back for now. I had spent all that time investigating the people around you so I could set you up. To think, Takuto Maruki, of all people, would be the mastermind behind this absurd situation. And he happens to be warping the very fabric of reality while ranting about making everyone's dreams come true. Talk about incomprehensible motives. I can't even wrap my head around such intentions. At any rate, we need to figure out our next steps. I think it'd be suicide to march back in there at the moment. We need intel first. If we're going to stand up to him, we have to know more than nothing. I'll do some investigating on my own. I hate that we have to do what he says. But Maruki told us we have to wait until January 9th. Let's meet up here next week. Although, I imagine both our lives will be very different if you choose to live in this reality as your friends have been.
But...
Thank you.
Yes. So sure. Excuse me? Hey, you have a minute?
Sweet! That moves!
Whoa! No way, man!
You're correct.
Hey! Do you think? No, but... I'm sorry.
Oh, man.
Really? Huh?
way!
Time to head home. Coincidence. Indeed. Yes.
It's me. I've uncovered a few things in my investigation this week, so I thought I'd share my findings with you. First, regarding Maruki himself. He's been researching the treatment of patients through changes in their cognitions since his college years. You already knew about that, correct? Maruki's work apparently had enough investors that he was planning to break ground on a research facility somewhere. And, as you know, those plans never came to fruition. His funding was cut off, and his research was ended for him. It's probable. However, we can't be certain of the reason why. At least with our current understanding. What was the purpose of his research into cognitive science? Doesn't it feel like there's more to the story? For example, maybe his research was stymied by someone else for their own reasons. Anyway, that's all I could dig up about Marugi's history. The only thing that's become clearer is his stance on using cognitive science. He's dead serious about saving people. He distorted reality itself to make his dream come true. I can only imagine how delighted he is right now. Ah, that reminds me. There was one more thing I wanted to tell you. About the reality Marugi's put us in. It seems that Akumara and Wakaba are both considered alive by all accounts. They aren't mere illusions or cognitive beings. They truly are alive and existing in this world. In fact, their deaths seem to have never taken place at all in this reality. Shido was the only one arrested on the crime of attempting to overthrow the government. It seems the Phantom Thieves were causing a stir in this society as well. But there's no record of your arrest now. Basically, in this reality, you and I haven't committed any crimes. I don't understand how Marugi was able to distort reality to such extremes. But at the very least, he was being honest when he told us that he'd make such revisions. And rather convenient ones. That's quite the funny joke. It makes me want to puke. Remaining in this Marugi revised reality means living under his thumb forever. And I refuse to live like that. I'll be the one to choose my path. That's how I've lived up to now. And it's going to continue from here till the end. But what about you? You saw them for yourself, didn't you? Your friends seem to have taken a liking to Maruki's version of reality. Don't tell me you've changed your mind after seeing them. Silence, huh? If you're going to run from this, please tell me as soon as possible. I don't want any unexpected complications popping up. That takes care of the info I wanted to share. See you soon.
Are you going somewhere tomorrow? With Akechi? You guys are really hitting it off lately. Of course, that's not a bad thing. Hey, so, about what you said before, you know, that stuff about my happiness? Sorry, it's nothing. Good night. So, you came. Based on the look in your eyes, I'm guessing your friends aren't going to be of any use to us. We need as much manpower as possible right now. I was hoping at least some of them would avoid being useless, but that seems to be beyond their capabilities. Well, there's no point in griping about it out here. Are you ready? As I mentioned yesterday, it's quite likely that we'll have to confront Marugi physically. If you're not prepared for such a contingency, then please go and take care of your affairs as quickly as possible. How about this? Now, let us depart.
Excuse me, Whoa! Hey guys.
Looks like we've all had the same idea.
Are you here to speak with him as well?
Kinda. So, he's not here?
He left around noon. Said he was meeting up with Akechi.
Sojiro said if we need to talk about stuff, we can use this place for a while.
Cool.
You know, he asked me the other day. Something along the lines of whether or not I'm okay with how things are. At first I didn't know what he was talking about, but as he kept going, his words started making my chest feel all tight.
I know what you mean. Never since then, it's like something isn't right in my heart anymore.
I have no complaints about my current life. On the contrary, in fact, I am truly happy with it. So in that case, what is this inkling of a feeling I have deep in my soul?
Damn it. I'm so bad at figuring out this sort of stuff. Hey, do you think maybe we're all running away from something super important? I've been kind of wondering for a while now. Maybe the reason his words hurt so much is because he's right. But I was too scared to admit that for some reason. That's why I pretended I didn't understand what he meant.
When I was speaking with him, I felt like I caught a glimpse of this mysterious sight. Something that shouldn't have happened. But still, I felt like I shouldn't turn away from it.
Same here.
And myself as well. It seems that we really have lost sight of something precious to us after all.
That might be. But I'm so scared to remember what it is. If I remember that, I feel like my life as I know it is gonna end.
Oh, Futaba.
But even still, I don't want to feel this way anymore either.
Me too.
Guess that's it, huh? He was trying to tell us all something important, and I bet he's probably still working on it somewhere. Ain't no way I'm gonna bail on him just so I can keep running from whatever it is.
When I had that strange experience you all mentioned, I saw him and the rest of us there together. I want to believe the connection we share here is a genuine one.
Well, I know if we don't do something soon, we're gonna lose our connection with him. Don't ask how I know. It just feels like the truth to me.
I admit I am happy right now, but I just can't accept the situation as it is. I'm done with trying to escape my problems.
Huh?
Well, if I must, all right.
Show me your true form!
He's got them surrounded.
Let's go.
Nice! I go down. The polar ability in my enemies.
Persona!
I'll see you. Keep it going! Persona! Manifest! I love it!
Step forward.
But can you use it? All right.
Huh.
Focus.
It seems they were not a very formidable opponent. Looks like there's a... It's a safe room. Now, let us depart. Hey! Hmm.
Thank you for coming. She's only sleeping. I've never had any intention of hurting her. Once her inner turmoil begins to settle, I'll have her remember her life as she wishes to live it.
The life that she wishes for, huh? Call it what you like. You're merely brainwashing people for your own satisfaction.
I'm wholly aware that some will interpret my acts that way. But if that self-satisfaction leads to the happiness of thousands of others, don't you agree that outcome is for the best? If I understand correctly, you went and checked in on your friends this past week. This reality is the one that they all wished for. Did any of them seem troubled by that fact? This reality is the true reality. All you have to do is recognize it as such. Once you do, you'll be just as happy as they are. Didn't you see it yourselves? Your friends don't just want to live these lives. They want you to choose this reality for yourselves and live happily too. Please, I want you to understand, for their sake, as well as yours. Time. For the sake of Yoshizawa-san and the rest of your friends, I... Huh?
Negotiations seem to have broken down.
I see. It seems we still haven't reached an understanding.
No. You're not serious, right? Please. I'm begging you, Senpai. Please let me live as Kasumi. But why? This pain is too much. Why can't I just leave it behind me? Kasumi is gone forever, and it's all my... all Sumire's fault! I can't live that kind of life! Please, don't try to stop me! If you do, then I'll...
How stubborn. No matter what you say to her, I doubt she'll understand. I don't think we have a choice in the matter here. I could take care of it for you right now. But you'd prefer her to leave here alive, right? Just hurry up and end this.
Please, don't make me do this.
Looks like you lost.
Why? Senpai. No. I can't go back to being Sumire. You saw it all for yourself, Senpai. It's my own fault that my sisters... Why don't you understand? Please. I beg you.
Yoshizawa-san. I can give you strength, so you don't have to suffer.
Doctor...
Tell me, if you want your pain to end, and desire to live as Kasumi...
I'll actualize it!
Sadly, she has lost sight of herself. She's in pain. Now, be her guide, and together, escape from the nightmare!
No! I can't! I don't want to go back to my life in cinders ever again!
What the hell? This so-called kindness of his disgusts me. Let's do this quick.
I refuse to go back! I'm happy here! This is where I belong!
I'll rescue you. The only way I know how.
It's gone totally berserk. We need to stop her persona!
I'll take that!
It ate the smaller one? What a pain. We'll have to beat it before it heals itself again.
It's time.
There.
None will stand in my way. Stop! For my joy.
Persona!
I will seize joy! I'll take that!
Persona!
Being such pathetic, soot-coated garbage!
You can't tell? It's her refusal to accept the truth.
We can't afford to waste time on this shit! Here it comes!
Think so.
Damn it, Skull. I told you not to rush in by yourself like that. At least it seemed to work out in our favor.
Our apologies for making you wait so long.
Is that
Akechi-kun and Dr. Maruki?
Yoshizawa's trapped by... Why is her persona doing this? What in the world is going on here?
So much of this shit makes no sense, but we'll cover it later. We've gotta stop her first, right, Joker?
All right, let's get in formation. Okay, guys, leave the navigation to me. Let's push it back.
Unbelievable. Why did they come here?
For my joy.
Feels pretty good.
It's time. All right.
I'll break them.
You've all... I can't believe you've thrown away your happiness just to come here and... And how? It's impossible.
You're Dr. Maruki, right?
That's right. More importantly, why are...
Dude, what the hell's Doc doing inside a palace?
He's ruling this palace is what he's doing.
What?
Not only that, he's the one who's generated this whole distorted reality. Isn't that right, Maruki-san?
All of this was done for your own joy.
Our joy?
That's right. I only wanted to grant your wishes. Each and every one.
Wait, you what? What do you mean? We never wish for anything like that.
Is that really true?
Huh?
No, never mind. So, you all intend to deny the reality I've created for you. If you want to fight me, then so be it. If you plan on changing my heart, that's fine too. But before that, I think there's still room for discussion here. Also, I believe taking care of Yoshizawa-san is more important than settling this issue right now.
Planning to run again?
We can get back to fighting if that's what you really want. But I think you're rather exhausted at the moment.
Yoshizawa-san!
There's still time.
February 3rd. I'll hear your final decision on the 3rd. If your views can't align with mine by then, we'll have no other choice but a physical altercation. As much as I would loathe that, I still can't give up what I've started. What I swore I'd do, on the day I lost everything that mattered to me.
I've lost his reading! I want to pursue him, but I doubt that's even possible right now.
Let's get out of here. Yoshizawa's got a rest anyway.
I'm still just as shocked as I was when we first came here. The navigators returned to our devices. A palace is visible in our own reality.
Does this mean reality's broken right now or something? Something to do with Dr. Maruki, anyway.
Hey, how much do you already know about this stuff?
So, Dr. Maruki...
he altered our reality... to make our dreams come true?
This is all too much for me to handle at once.
Apologies for the interruption. Mind if I interject? That's right! Akechi! There's no reason to be defensive. Had I wished to kill you all, I would have simply done so already.
So you're not here to fight us?
I've already put our feud behind me. Not only that. Since he and I both refuse to accept reality as Maruki sees fit to make it, we currently have the same goal.
So what you're saying is you're using him.
What about the rest of you? Considering how you were all living your ideal lives in that other reality, until you decided to come here, Maruki seems to be telling the truth about taking your happiness into consideration. While his heart is distorted, he is quite different from the adults whose hearts you've changed so far. Now that you know his intentions, I'm most interested in learning whether you still plan on fighting him or not.
What do you mean?
I'm up against someone with the power to distort reality as we know it. The more allies on my side, the better. If we all share the same goal, shouldn't we join forces and improve our odds? I'll be going now. Be sure to consider my point.
Hey! Hey!
Jeez.
Yoshizawa, are you alright?
Oh, yes. I'm sorry that I caused you all so much trouble.
No, you don't need to apologize.
We should probably go our separate ways for now and discuss it at a better time.
Yeah, tomorrow we can... Oh yeah, third semester's starting up tomorrow, right?
I guess we're going back to school, huh? We still don't have any idea what we want to do from here on out, though.
We've got time. Maruki said he'll wait until February 3rd before... Let's really think it over before making our decision.
Yo, welcome back. I didn't know you guys were out together. Wait, what's wrong, Futaba?
Hey, Sojiro, is Mom?
Mom? You mean Wakaba? Well, what about her?
Nah, it's nothing. It's just I happen to remember something about her, that's all.
I see. Okay, then. You know, I caught myself thinking about her earlier, too. Odd coincidence, huh? Well, I'm gonna head home for the night. How about you, Futaba?
I'm gonna stick around a bit longer.
I see. Don't stay out too late, all right? The place is all yours. You've got school tomorrow, too, so get to bed at a reasonable time.
gone again. Sojiro sees it that way too now.
Oh yeah! I forgot to tell you what happened before we came to rescue you. We all ended up here at the same time after you left for Odaiba.
What was that?
Wait, you're...
What the?
I'm... Oh yeah, that's right! Why were you human, Mona?
Yeah! You're supposed to be a cat!
I am not a...
Oh wait. Yeah, I guess I am a cat.
How did we never realize?
You know, we've got more important things to do than sit around here and figure out what happened to us.
That's right!
You said he was headed to Odaiba, correct? And with Akechi-kun?
We need to find them!
Once we got to Odaiba, we spotted the palace. You know how the rest goes. You were fighting this whole time, weren't you? While I was just bumming around town without a care. I'm sorry. Deep down, I always suspected something strange was happening. Something wrong. But being with my mom was so much fun, I stopped trying to figure it out. But I totally snapped out of it thanks to you. I'm all good now. Yep, no worries. I'm fine. With... School's tomorrow, right? You better not stay up late. You might end up oversleeping.
We've all been through too much today. Let's try to get some sleep.
What? Yep.
It's been quite some time. We have finally succeeded in reaching you. You have been imprisoned once more. This time, not by the God of Control, but a different entity, one who's bound you through your future. However, you held fast to your free will and believed in your bonds, allowing your friends to regain their own realities. You are on the verge of grasping a potential reality once more. Our meeting again now, within this place, is proof enough. It seems the time has come. We are merely beings who provide aid to humans as they carry out their will. You must be the one to determine the path and actions to take. If the will of rebellion still thrives within you, then we will surely meet again.
Lady Lavenza told you that? We ought to tell everyone else that, too. Let's all meet up after school.
Good morning. I'm sorry. I can't believe what I tried to do to you two. I genuinely cannot apologize enough for what happened.
Oh, come on. There's no need for that. More importantly, how have you been?
Physically, I'm fine, but mentally, to be entirely honest, I'm all mixed up. My memories are still pretty fuzzy, and I haven't really processed everything yet. I'm going to need a little time to myself to think things through. I have to figure out what to do with myself from here on.
Time's up.
We have to choose our own path, eh? Akechi had mentioned that we needed to determine what we'll do from here on out. It seems he was right.
We can accept this reality, but that means we'll have to fight Dr. Maruki, right?
That's right. We have to confront Maruki and steal his desire. In a way, it's business as usual for us.
Dr. Maruki is an adult with a warped desire, but that desire is just a wish for us all to be happy. Right?
I admit, it's nothing similar to the desires we've seen in the likes of Shido and Kamoshida.
The Phantom Thieves only change the hearts of evildoers. Dr. Maruki is quite different from our past targets.
Well, I think we already know what we gotta do. Haru's right. Dr. Maruki ain't a shitty adult at all. There are probably plenty of folks out there living all happy in this reality. Who knows? Maybe Dr. Maruki is actually doing the right thing. But we all still feel like this reality is wrong, right? We decide what's right for ourselves. That's what we all agreed on when we went after him in the palace. If changing Doc's heart fixes our reality, then I'm gonna do it. So somebody say something?
Sorry, I was just thinking about how right you are, Ryuichi.
So we're going to change our target's heart not to reform society, but to acquire the reality we believe in. That doesn't sound bad at all.
Then it's unanimous.
Well, that means our next step is pretty clear. Right. Maruki said that he'd be willing to fight if we are too. It's safe to assume he's expecting us to infiltrate his palace.
That reminds me. You know that, reality-bending stuff? Why is Doc able to do that anyway?
I've been wondering the same thing. Even if he was the top cognitive science expert, that wouldn't be enough for him to do all of this.
If we're going to fight Maruki, we'd better dig up some more intel on him first.
Good day. This is Livenza speaking.
Huh?
Your will of rebellion has reached new heights. We would like to aid that will, if you find it agreeable.
Wait, how is she even calling you?
And how'd she know how high our wills are? Did she tap your line or something?
Her timing was just too perfect. Maybe she actually did.
I have performed no form of electronic surveillance whatsoever.
Apparently, she can hear you.
There's something I wish to tell you regarding your current situation. However, I'm reaching the limit of my communication ability with this method. Let us meet in person tomorrow. It would be best for me to select a location considered easy to reach by all parties. Therefore, let us convene at your school.
At Shujin?
Wait, she'll be at the school? Livenza will?
In that case, I'll see you tomorrow.
She hung up.
Is she really gonna go to our school? Just walk through the front gates like nothing?
I'm not sure what to make of it. But since we've determined our goal and Lavenza's offer to help us, I'd call that progress of some sort.
All we have left is whatever we discuss tomorrow at school, plus whether or not we're going to team up with Akechi.
Considering what he told us, really does seem like we share an end goal with Akechi, but...
Well, I think we ought to team up.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Are you sure?
Dr. Maruki's strong enough to change reality itself. If we're gonna fight him, we're gonna need Akechi's help.
Plus, if he does betray us again, we'll just take him out too.
I guess that settles that.
Let's all meet at Shujin tomorrow. I'll take care of figuring out how to get Yusuke and Futaba in the school.
I appreciate the effort. Thank you.
All right. Let's head home for now. For real? No. Hey. Listen up!
All right.
Okay.
Right. Let's turn in for the night.
What is the answer?
Hey, wait! Seriously?
That means...
This is it.
Correct!
No way.
Nice going! You've been awfully busy lately. Don't forget to eat lunch. As for myself, be sure to order some jelly-filled bread and... Hmm? That's... Yeah, it's just fluttering down the hall like a graceful... Wait, that's not my point. Let's follow it. Hey! Oh! For real? Lady Lavenza.
Hello. Thank you for coming. I see. Exchanging common expressions upon meeting like humans do, it has a rather pleasant feeling. But that is irrelevant. Let's turn to the matter at hand. As I told you yesterday, there's something I wish to tell you. But first, please gather your other friends here.
Here? You want to meet in the nurse's office?
This place is filled with the cognition of bed rest. Maintaining my existence in a reality controlled by someone like Maruki is no simple feat. But the exhaustion that it induces is limited by this place's cognition, so I may converse with you all in person here.
I... see.
Let us continue this conversation once everyone involved has convened. Until that time, I will provide my eyes a much-needed rest.
Wait, rest? Lady Lavenza? I guess we should get everyone in here. Infiltration? Success!
I'm rather surprised no one took notice of us.
Considering how I don't have an adequate excuse for the school to approve your being here, we are lucky it went as well as it did.
As long as you maintain an air of confidence, you can fool just about anybody into thinking you belong. I must say, though, I hadn't expected you to actually reach out to me for something like this.
Well, it's just as we said before. We've accepted your offer to work together.
Now's not the time to let personal stuff get in the way of our goal. But if you ever betray us again, we'll make sure you regret it.
All right then. That's no concern of mine anyway. Remember what I told you all before. We share a mutual interest. Until Maruki is defeated, we have a deal to uphold.
It appears that everyone's arrived. Does this mean... you're ready to begin?
Ain't that Arline?
Yes. I wished to speak with you about the circumstances that led this Maruki to alter reality as you know it, as well as the true nature of his power.
You know all of that?
I admit there will be a degree of speculation involved, but only to a small extent. First, I will explain the situation with the current reality. I believe that Maruki has altered the cognition of the masses. In other words, it's thought that the alterations he's made are the result of his meddling with mementos.
He changed mementos? How is that even possible?
Wait, Don't forget about our experience with the Metanav and Maruki's palace. Seems like this kind of thing has a habit of sticking around despite our expectations.
Mementos is the cognition of the masses given form. If that man is truly capable of controlling individuals' cognitions, and that man were also to gain access to mementos, it would be no surprise that he could impact everyone's cognitions and affect reality itself.
Could he really have done all that? I mean, it's assumed that Dr. Maruki has the power to control cognition, right?
Exactly. That man's controlling of cognition... Let's see. Why don't we refer to his power as actualization? Most likely, that actualization is a power unique to a persona. In other words, this man named Maruki is...
He's a persona user?
That's impossible. There's no way to have a persona and a palace at the same time.
Determining when Maruki first awakened to his power is wholly impossible. However, by the time he crossed your paths, there's no doubt that he was making use of his actualization, although he may have only been doing so subconsciously.
Even if it is just his subconscious, he's using a persona in the real world.
So his ability to make Yoshizawa-san think she was Kasumi-chan...
It was most likely through the use of actualization.
Still though, even if we assume that Maruki has unique persona abilities, such as the case with him and myself, we still need to determine how he used that power on Mementos as a whole, rather than a single individual.
Right. Even if there were some kind of power that could affect Mementos, it's on a whole other level from what we've seen so far. A single person just shouldn't be capable of all that.
That's true. Changing reality just by thinking about it isn't something humans do. It's something that, like, gods do.
And what if he became such a god?
What? The god of control.
Indeed. The being in Mementos that you all defeated was a false deity that the masses deludedly clung to. It is easy to conclude that Maruki simply took over the false god's position when it disappeared.
Took over his position? What do you mean? So you're saying society thinks of Doc as a god now or something?
Now, the Phantom Thieves are the ones who gained the masses' support after defeating this so-called god of control. So it would follow that the masses would turn to the Phantom Thieves next as their savior. In that case, why did they instead turn to Maruki, who did none of the work the Phantom Thieves did?
Wait, you what? What do you mean? We never wish for anything like this.
Is that really true?
It's most likely because...
What?
After we defeated the God of Control, we wished for reality to be like Dr. Maruki described it. And it happened?
I don't remember doing any wishing with you guys and Doc. I mean, when would we have even had the chance to?
What about our counseling?
Looks like you all walked right into the spider's parlor.
There's no way of knowing how many of those situations were intentionally orchestrated by that man. However, the result is still the same. A desire for his actualization was seeded within your hearts. Thus, I have no doubt that it was your own desires that led to their actualization.
So this is all our fault, huh?
We're the ones who told him the cognitive world really exists, too.
Right, let's fight! If this is our own fault, we've gotta be the ones to fix it.
Yes. This realization changes none of what we must do.
Very well. Then allow me to proceed. This world is in a very unstable condition currently. On the day that the God of Control fused mementos with the real world, the merging was undone through your efforts, and the two worlds are now attempting to return to their initial states.
So, what you're saying is this world has reverted to a state where the fusion with mementos hasn't been totally undone. That explains why Maruki's palace was visible in Odaiba.
Even as we speak, Maruki is still influencing this world in places where its boundaries are blurred. As slow a pace as it may be, he still continues to actualize the world of the masses as a whole. Should this continue, reality shall merge with mementos once more. The two worlds will again become one. When that happens, anyone trapped within the actualized world can never again awaken to the original one.
No!
This issue goes beyond the masses as well. Although you are all Persona users, it would be next to impossible to defy Maruki in a world completely under his control. To be clear, once the two worlds conclude their fusion, there will be no chance of your success in this mission. And I believe this fusion will conclude in 1 month's time.
We only have a month.
If memory serves me correctly, February 3rd was the date Dr. Maruki gave us, right? Could he have possibly chosen the time limit based on when his actualization will be completed?
It's possible.
If that's the case, we don't got another choice except to steal his treasure by then.
We'll need to secure our route to the treasure by the 2nd so we can send our calling card. Then, on the day of, we're most likely going to have to fight Maruki.
Allow me to produce the calling card. This is certain to be our final card. I'll pour my heart and soul into its creation.
Be that as it may, there are still some unsolved questions. Right?
What's the deal with the palace's name? Doesn't seem to affect the app's functions, but...
That must also be a product of Maruki's cognition. He most likely learned that you could somehow infiltrate the metaverse. As long as he permits your existence, your method of infiltration will not entirely disappear either. However, in his heart he must have feared you would learn his identity as the palace's ruler. Perhaps such a feeling took the form of hiding the ruler's name from you.
But in that case, why didn't Dr. Maruki just actualize us out of existence entirely?
Maruki told us he wants us to accept his world. It may be hard to believe, but since we mutually benefit from his actualization, maybe he really does want us to submit.
Sorry, even if it does fix shit for us, I just can't accept the world getting treated like that. Let's start the infiltration tomorrow, yeah? And you? Sound good?
You're willing to ask me as well.
Duh, dude! The Phantom Thieves don't act unless it's a unanimous vote!
Fine then. You know I have no intention of accepting Maruki's world anyway.
Then that settles that.
Wait, what about Yoshizawa-san?
We may not have summoned her as one of the Phantom Thieves. This definitely involves her as well.
Maybe we should fill her in on our situation once she comes to terms with her own. What she does with that information, though, that's up to her.
Right.
If that concludes matters, I shall continue to watch over you, Trickster. Please show me the path that you choose for humanity.
Guess we might as well close up for the night. Hey, once you're done washing that, you can go ahead and call it a... welcome.
Yoshizawa?
Have a seat. She's here to see you, right? Now, don't worry about finishing up. I'll take care of it later.
Sorry for coming over so late. And thank you for the coffee. It's delicious. Would you mind if I got something off my chest? Thank you. So, to tell the truth, I saw you all go into the nurse's office today, and, I sort of eavesdropped on your conversation. You've all found the paths you want to take, and are following them with such confidence, whereas I'm simply... Like Dr. Maruki said before, I ran from the truth. I couldn't handle the fact that Kasumi died because of my actions. My memories are still a bit hazy, but even when I remembered that I'm really Sumire, I didn't want to accept it. I was still running from reality, where Kasumi is gone, where I had to live for Kasumi instead of as her. No. Like I said earlier, I realized something when I saw you all striving to push onward. I can't keep running like this, but now that Kasumi's gone, I have no idea what to do with myself. Senpai, what should I do? You can be awfully firm sometimes, Senpai, but you're absolutely correct. I must thank you for allowing me to unload all of this onto you. I'm still not completely sure what I should do, but I plan to think more on it. I've got to figure out what to do with my life now.
Let's reform society! Okay.
Beautifully executed.
Yeah?
Right.
Very well. Let us go.
Oh, it's... Hello, everyone. You're going to fight Dr. Maruki, yes? Please. Take me with you.
But... You can't go in dressed like that.
Please? I'm done running away. I can't keep relying on people, like Senpai. I want to live life as Sumire.
Color me impressed.
Looks like she'll do just fine here.
Thank you.
In that case, we gotta come up with a code name for you.
What now?
It wouldn't be right if you were the only one going by your real name, you know?
Oh, you're right.
Joker, got any suggestions?
Oh, Oh, that's right. Sumire in English is Violet. Yeah, that sounds awesome.
Violet. Yes, let's go with that.
Excellent. Now remember, everyone, Violet, not Violent, Violet.
Yes, thank you for clarifying.
I am surrounded by absolute fools. Are we done? We should probably get moving.
I know, jeez. Come on, Violet, let's roll.
Yeah.
Yes. Joker!
I'll just add this.
Security level crazy!
Appreciate it, but allow me. I chose to stand on my own and fight. It's time I stop being helpless. I hung my head low and took your hand. But I knew all along, deep down, pretending to be Kasumi was not the right way.
The weak, insecure spirit dies today!
Violet!
You were the one! The only one who stayed true to yourself! Come, Sandrion! If you don't answer my call now, how else can we make our dream come true?
Such tenacity. It seems to fit you better than ever before. The glass slippers are the icon of glory. Not just for you, but the other girl within you as well. I am thou. Thou art I. Are you prepared for your debut? The ball awaits.
Certainly.
That's it. I'm done running from myself.
Yeah, you tell him!
Go Violet! Give him hell!
Yes! Let's do this, Sondrion!
Let's dance! Shove them, Sondrion!
All enemies are down!
Go Violet!
They're dead for!
A perfect 10!
Sorry for troubling you. I'll be fine now.
You were as impressive as always out there. Well done, Violet.
Thank you. I still have a lot to learn, though. I promise I'll do my best not to slow you down.
Come on, you don't have to be so formal with us.
Sorry. And the same goes for you too, Joker-senpai. I hope you'll still be there for me.
Thou art I. My vow stands renewed in pursuit of the truth. In breaking free of doubt, the chain that impedes thee is thy strength of heart made manifest. With the rebirth of the faith persona, thou hast obtained the winds of blessing that shall guide thee to the furthest depths.
Alright.
Alright, let's kick some ass!
Yes.
See it.
What's up with this room? The entire palace has been rather bizarre, but this room is rather strange in its own way.
CRT TV, huh? Talk about old school. Look, it's even got a built-in VCR.
Maybe we've got to watch some TV first?
I highly doubt that.
Actually, there's a chance he's right. There appears to be a tape by the VCR.
Well, it appears we don't have any choice but to watch the tape, do we? Of course, it could possibly just be a trap.
Nothing's happening.
It's making some strange noises. Could it be broken?
Do you think we should try whacking it?
Please don't.
Oh, it's playing. Stay on guard, everyone.
How are you feeling today, Rumi?
Sorry I came empty-handed. I've just been so busy with the research lately. I haven't had the chance to pick up any part-time work.
I know. I'll buy you flowers the next time I come. Do you remember that wildflower field we used to go to back in high school? You really loved it there, didn't you? Oh, would you prefer if I brought you some snacks instead? Which should I bring? Sweet or salty? I know you like both, so... Actually, I have some news for you today. So first, I've finished my paper. The other thing is... they caught the culprit. He's in police custody now. You don't need to worry anymore. Of course, that doesn't mean everything's over and done with, but things are going to proceed as they ought to. My cognitive science is the study of people's hearts and how they guide people's views of the world. Everyone comprehends the world in a different way, depending on their cognition. So basically, if one could tap into a person's cognitive world, one would even be able to alter how that person views reality.
in every way. That's what my paper's all about. Here I am, going way over your head with this stuff, just like always. But anyway, I've recently met someone who thinks my research could be fruitful. If everything moves forward as planned, they may even fund my work. At that point, I'd be the first professional scientist in the world. My goal is to find a way to stop crime by putting my research into action. Many of the criminals in this world are deluded to the point of seeing everything through a distorted lens. If I could change their cognitions, it would stop them from committing crimes before they even considered them. And if I were to succeed, the things that happened to you would never happen to anyone else again. I want to save you. No, not just you. I want to save the whole world with my cognitive science. Well, at least I know your family would appreciate it.
Takuto.
Rumi, it's me. Are you all right? Can you talk?
Takuto. Family. My family. Dad. Mom. No. Please. Please don't go.
Ah! Rumi. Rumi, it's okay. Calm down.
Give them back! Give me my mom and dad!
You want power?
These migraines are... Damn it! Don't worry, someone's coming to help.
I believe it was most likely a post-traumatic episode. Memories of the incident must have resurfaced due to some sort of stimuli, like certain imagery or phrasing.
Phrasing? I'm so sorry, Rumi. It's all my fault. Deep down, I knew I could end all crime across the world. It still wouldn't bring your family back. What you truly need is to be set free from that horrible tragedy. But... how can I do that?
Must seek me.
What? What was that?
Takuto, please stop this. I want to forget.
Forget? I wish I could do something to... Oh. But wait, by altering a subject's cognition, by changing their heart, any related trauma is eliminated.
You must seek me.
So, by that logic, all that pain, Rumi's trauma and everyone else's, it can be undone.
Seek me. I am that who manifests thought himself. I shall echo your blasphemous fury with reality, so that we may together change the world. Now, call me forth.
Yes. I'll do it. I don't care who you may be. Lend me your strength. Please, help me save Rumi's life. What was that? Rumi, are you okay?
Who are you?
Rumi, it's me!
I'm really sorry, but I don't know who you are.
Rumi, what do you mean?
I've just gone through surgery. Ever since I was born, I've been unwell. I lost my parents when I was young. So I live with my grandparents in the countryside now.
When you were... young? You can't. It's me, Rumi. Don't you remember me?
I really am sorry, but I have no idea what you're talking about. Well, I'm going to be discharged from here pretty soon, now that I've finished my last round of surgery. I can't wait to see my grandparents again, and show them how well I've recovered.
This is...
We're
her memories actually revised? Wait, was that voice really...
Are you alright?
That's absurd. How could something like... Oh, I mean, it's nothing. I'm just glad you're doing better now. She remembers nothing of the incident. So, Furumi...
By the way, what are you doing in my room? How do you know my name?
Oh, well, I'm, Sorry. I mistook you for someone else.
Another person?
Yeah. My girlfriend's name is Rumi, too.
Really? That's so nice to hear.
Yeah.
Huh?
Looks like I really messed up finding the right room. I really am sorry to disturb you.
So I know this might sound odd, but if you'd like to meet again sometime...
Thank you for the offer, but... I'm sorry. I'm going to be getting busier than ever soon, so I don't believe we'll be meeting again.
Really? But what about your girlfriend?
She's... passed away. That's why I won't be coming here anymore.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I hope you feel better soon. And I know the people who care about you wish the same.
That was... Dr. Maruki, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was.
Based on what we've seen, we can surmise that Dr. Maruki's memory was somehow on that videotape.
The way that woman was acting at the end, that's just how it went for me, too. So he rewrote her cognition.
Considering what he was saying in the video, that might have been the moment he first awakened to his ability.
Could Dr. Maruki possibly have wanted us to watch this memory?
I don't think that's the case. It's possible that this is just an old memory he tried to bury in his unconscious mind.
Still, if this actually occurred, there's no mistaking it for a trivial memory. This is clearly important to Maruki.
Whether for good or bad, it appears that this incident is what led Dr. Maruki to his current mission.
You're right.
Damn it! Just hearing it from you's pissing me off. You've come so far. What problem could they possibly have now?
I tried negotiating in person with the professor and the investors, but they simply wouldn't listen. Due to the lack of concrete evidence, all further research and funding in the field of cognitive science will cease. They told me it's already over and done with. But why now, of all times? When they first saw my paper, they were positively beaming with excitement!
And the research lab in Odaiba? They're not going through with that anymore?
Yep. Damn it. To hell with their concrete evidence! How are we supposed to get any evidence if we can't perform the research first? If we can change the cognition of trauma victims, their suffering can be eliminated. Who knows how many people could be saved with this research? How much more obvious could its benefits be?
So, do you really think the lack of evidence is the reason they shut it all down?
It makes absolutely no sense to me. After all the time and money spent, to just cut off my research because it wasn't all proven sound immediately. Even if that was the result of some kind of conspiracy, what could I do about it? It's not like I have any proof.
I see. So, what are you gonna do now? Sponsors have backed out, so I doubt the college is gonna let you keep using their labs.
I'm done with that college. They have nothing for me at this point. I'll look for work elsewhere while I keep fleshing out that research paper. Eventually, I'll prove the existence of the cognitive world. Once I've done that, no one will be able to complain. Rumi, I swear I'm going to do it. I have the power now. It cost me my life with you. So I'm going to rescue everyone from their pain. I don't care how long it takes me. It's going to happen.
So that was another of Dr. Maruki's memories?
Yes, I believe so. Seemed to be a much more recent memory than the first one we saw, though. His research was cut off.
So after the incident with his girlfriend, he progressed in his research to harness cognitive science as a healing practice. However, his research was shut down, and his career along with it. All he had left was his resolve to prove his research valid, then use it to save people. That seems to be the message delivered by the videos we found.
It must have been his dream, to use his research to save people here.
If that sounds good to you, would you prefer we just turn around and go home?
That isn't an option.
Yeah, what she says. If anything, we've got to pull out all the stops to win this one.
Well, the vote was unanimous.
So, you're Sumire Yoshizawa, huh? I'm Dr. Maruki. I'll be your counselor. First of all, thank you for coming to see me.
Yes. Thank you for seeing me. I'm sorry. I'm not sure what to discuss. I only came here today because my parents wanted me to.
That's fine. So, do you want to just chat until our time's up then?
Chat, huh?
Of course. It's not really possible for us to talk about things you don't want to discuss anyway. I've also got some sweets and some salty snacks there. Feel free to have at them.
Oh yes, thank you so much.
So, let's start with, how about, what'd you eat for lunch yesterday? I'll go first. The other day, a friend of mine gave me a ton of apples. I've grown tired of just eating them by themselves. Yesterday, I thought, why not try using them as a meal ingredient? So, I tried making an apple dish for lunch, but that didn't turn out too hot. What do you think I ended up making?
I have no clue.
Shrimp and chili sauce. With apples. You know how sweet and sour pork can have pineapple in it? I was going for that, but...
Sounds like it didn't work for you. Apples do make for good ingredients, though. If you grate them, you can make a surprisingly versatile sauce. I use it in plenty of my food. It's pretty nutritious and good for digestion.
You cook, Yoshizawa-san? I'm impressed that you care so much about nutrition. You must be really on top of things.
I'm just active, that's all. I'm a gymnast. My coach has told me more than once to be conscious of everything I eat.
I see. How's practice going for you? Has it been rough lately?
It has been rough. I mean, it's nothing I can't handle, but it's not going well. I don't even know what I want to do anymore.
Sorry to hear it. Do you enjoy gymnastics?
I'm not even sure of that. My older sister and I made a promise. We'd both compete and win the biggest gymnastics awards in the world, but she passed away. She protected me from a car. I stole Kasumi's dream away from her. I can't do it anymore. I can't just go on like this. If Kasumi were here instead, I know she'd make her dream come true. Only Kasumi could have done it. No matter how long I try to compete, it's not going to change anything. I'm sorry.
There's no need for you to apologize in here. If there's something you need to get off your chest, please do so.
Sometimes, I can't help but think things would have been better if I were Kasumi Yoshizawa. After all, just wishing to make her dream come true does nothing for her in reality.
Making dreams come true, huh? Well, I don't think your train of thought is strange at all, Yoshizawa-san. In fact, wanting to become somebody else isn't necessarily an entirely bad thing.
You
You think so?
Everyone is capable of changing themselves. Your imagination's your only limit. That's why, if you aspire to be more like another person, it's actually possible. Thought exercises like, would that person do this? Or realizations like, that person wouldn't do that. These sorts of thoughts can lead people to change themselves in ways that more closely mirror the target person. Can you still imagine what your sister was like?
Yes.
If your sister were in your shoes, what do you think she'd do?
Well, she wouldn't cry. If she had the time to do that, she'd just practice more instead. Dr. Maruki, I want to become Kasumi.
I know. And I'm sure you can too. Just believe in yourself. How about it? Are you feeling any better now?
Yes. I feel like a weight's been lifted off of me. You're amazing, Doctor.
It's no big deal. Still, it seems like my counseling approach does some good after all.
How to put it, but I feel like I've been reborn all over again.
Really? I'm very glad to hear it. Feel free to drop by again sometime, should anything come up. We can even just have a chat, like today.
Thank you. Then we could pick up where we left off talking about...
Something the matter?
Now that I think about it, I'm not any good at cooking. I don't know why I said those things earlier. My younger sister's the one who was really great at it.
That's right. Kasumi Yoshizawa?
Yes? What is it?
Oh, nothing. I'm so glad I was able to help you. Good luck with your training.
Right. I'll do my best. For Sumire's sake, and mine. Was that... Yes, it was a counseling session I had with Dr. Maruki. It was just after Kasumi, after my sister, passed away. From that moment on, I lived my life really believing I was Kasumi.
It was all due to the rewriting of your cognition. His actualization, as we've started calling it.
Okay, but I've been wondering something. So, it was only Sumire who believed that she was Kasumi, right? I assumed someone in your family or one of your friends would have noticed you going by the wrong name right away.
Well, I can certainly remember being called Kasumi by everyone else, too.
It might be more accurate to say you misheard or misunderstood the name you were being called. Like everyone kept calling you Sumire, but your cognition made you hear it as Kasumi.
So that's why nobody thought it was weird, including her folks and herself. Damn.
This must be part of the whole salvation nonsense Maruki's trying to pull over on us.
That memory may have been kept here in video form because he truly does wish for Violet to be happy with life.
I admit, I really did feel saved in that moment when I became Kasumi, but at the same time, I ran from my life as Sumire. I'm genuinely grateful for what Dr. Maruki did for me, but I'm done running. Let's get going.
So, what brings you back here after all these years?
That's a comprehensive study on the research you tried to shut down all these years ago.
I know how to read. What I meant was, why are you bringing this to me now?
Oh, this is just a quick visit out of spite. I wanted to show you in person that I found the concrete evidence you had discontinued my research over.
So it appears. I'll admit you've impressed me on that point, at least. But such praise does nothing now. All this discussion is in the past. Why can't you just let it stay there and move on?
No can do, Professor. Cognitive science has made too great an impact on this world to be abandoned like that.
What are you saying?
The psychotic breakdown incidents. The sudden changes of heart in adults that the Phantom Thieves claim to make. I'm nearly willing to call these events concrete evidence of cognitive science in action. How about you? And the one person pulling the strings in the background of this, Congressman Masayo Shishido. He seems to be confessing to all sorts of crimes now that the Phantom Thieves have changed his heart. Years ago, Shido took notice of my research, stole it away from me, and made others develop it for his own gain. Not only that, he used cognitive science somehow to induce the politically motivated psychotic breakdowns. Now, you're heavily involved in that series of events, aren't you?
What are you planning on doing with me?
Oh, nothing at all. As I said before, I only came here out of spite. That paper, my work, is going to change the world.
Change the world? And where's the money for that? Where's the power to do it? You're no Shido. What can someone like you actually do?
That paper there is just the first step. I've learned how to change the cognition of not just an individual, but all of humanity. And I will do it. No matter how long it takes.
Gah! Enough of this drivel. Get out of my office and don't show your face here again, hear me?
What is this?
What's your problem now?
Huh? You don't see this? The sky just...
The time has come.
This voice...
The
time is finally at hand. I am the other you, dwelling in the realm of mankind's hearts.
The other... me? Wait, the realm of mankind's hearts? Are you telling me this realm is...
You may have no knowledge of it, but I have been at your side for much longer than our current meeting. Finally, your reality and the sea of hearts from which I came have truly become one in this moment. Now, the time for your unjustly persecuted ideology is at hand. I am thou. Thou art I.
That's it. I finally get it. To think it'd be so...
Hey, what are you mumbling about? I told you to get out!
Yes. I'll be on my way. Finally. Now I can finally...
Shido!
To think he was the one who stymied Dr. Maruki's research.
You know, I've been wondering ever since we saw the earlier video. Do you think there was some kind of connection between my mom's cognitive science research and Dr. Maruki's?
After he crushed Maruki's chance at researching the field, he had his own pawns do it for him instead. Although I doubt Shido's researchers knew anything about the subject in the way Maruki did. That sounds exactly like the kind of plan that man would scheme up.
That bastard! Wait, now's not the time to get pissed about that.
There's another thing about that video nobody's mentioned yet. That being that appeared near the end was most likely Maruki's persona. The sky did turn red like that. I wonder if that was the day we fought against the God of Control. Lady Lavenza did tell us that reality and mementos were merged together during that time. As you've all seen for yourselves, a full awakening to a persona can't happen unless you're within the metaverse. That would mean Maruki really did awaken to his persona in that video. And at the same time, he attained the ability to meddle with mementos, the cognition of the masses.
So it is just as Lavenza had told us.
The sheer number of coincidences necessary for this to happen is just...
At any rate, now we have a better grasp of past events. I'm fairly certain that was a memory Maruki wouldn't want us to have seen, either.
Yeah!
We don't have the time for these questions anyhow. Let's go.
Yes.
Persona!
There.
There, Persona! Let's finish this!
Oh, yeah! Feel my power! Persona! Yeah! Persona!
Persona!
All will be revealed!
The death! Victory is ours!
You'll pay! I'm getting a warm, tingly feeling from all this power!
This appears to be quite the paradise. I assume Maruki's trying to convey that the world will turn into something like this if we allow him to abuse his research.
A paradise.
Wait, but this is a dead end, right? And we still haven't found the treasure.
Look again.
The shimmery thing?
No doubt about it. That's our treasure.
That also means we've secured our route.
All right. All we got left is send in the calling card. Oh, wait. How are we supposed to do that this time?
That's right. Dr. Maruki's been here in the palace this entire time, hasn't he?
I'm sure Maruki's well aware that the Phantom Thieves send out their calling cards the day before their heists. Considering his actions up until now, I highly suspect he'll attempt to directly intervene in some way that day. My money's on him trying it with Joker.
Good point. In that case, I'll leave the calling card in your hands, Joker.
We could just set up an ambush and destroy him once he steps in our trap, too.
No way are we doing that!
Our goal in coming here is to return reality to its original state, not to beat up Dr. Maruki.
It was merely a joke. After all, you're all well aware that Maruki's influence on reality goes well beyond this palace. If we make the wrong move in here, we could get eliminated outside the palace, since we lack our personas there. It'd be a safer strategy to change Maruki's heart, just as you all wish.
We're finally changing his heart. If we steal Dr. Maruki's treasure, everything will go back to the way it was, right?
I don't know for sure, but most likely.
Yeah, of course.
We've all come so far. We can't just give up now.
We gotta stick to our own reality.
About the time limit. Dr. Maruki told you it was February 3rd, correct?
Yeah, he isn't like anything we've faced before. We should get as strong as we can before that fight.
What would you like to do?